Good evening po. Ayan. Last session. Saan na sila? Talaga yata wala upang ako'y iyong piliin pa. Paano mahiyari ngayong ako'y di mo pansin? Paano mo malalaman sa'yo'y may pagtingin? Lagi na lamang sa'king isipan. Sana ito'y iyong maramdaman. Masabi ko na sana na minamahal kita. Doon mo lang malalaman pag-ibig ko'y ang kamang. Ayan, pangarap ka na lang ba o magiging katotohanan pa? Mahal ka ng iba, ngunit di bali na kahit mahal mo siya, mahal naman kita. Magandang gabi, welcome to the last session of Teacher Mary's FB Live tonight. Greet muna tayo, hi to sis Charina, hello to Mamweng. Sarap naman ng background music. Ayan, hello sa ever supportive na si Sis Risa Garcia. Hello to Maria. Nice blouse, tita. We are watching. Hello, Apuson. Thank you, Nam. And then, sa background music na lang ako. Ayan. Good evening, Vince. Good evening, Judy Limon Policarpio. Ayan, colorful. Ayan. Ngunit di bali na kahit mahal mo siya, mahal naman kita. Ayan. Hi to Mami Connie Franco. Hi Mami. Ayan po, magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Natapos natin ang ating 15 session. Ay, 25 sessions. Ayan. So, welcome po sa inyong lahat. Hi to Sir Gerald Bonito Crisostomo. Hello to my babe, Noemi Tayag Fernandez. Hello po sa inyong lahat. I hope akma na yung bibig ko sa sounds na lumalabas dyan sa inyo. Kahapon delay din, no? Mukha akong cartoon na salisalita. Yung parang nakadub ako. Ayan, let's continue. Tatapusin pa rin natin yung The Psychology of Love, okay? So, nasa number 5 na tayo. Pero, before nung number 5, uulitin lang natin. Binigyan natin to ng title na ilabas mo na, huwag mong pigilin, The Psychology of Love. Bakit? Because I would like you to know what kind of lover are you. Kailangan mailabas nyo na yon kung anong tunay na lover kayo. So that hindi kayo mawawala, just in case dun sa mga naghahanap na nakatulad ko, ayan, alam nyo kung paano, diba? Yung what kind of lover are you. We studied yung 1973 theory of love, which is the color wheel theory of love. And then we have talked about dun sa primary types of love. Diba yung Eros, which is more on emotional plus physical, more on erotic love. And then we've got the Ludos, which is more of the game, okay? Yung player, yung mga... they go for love as a game and sex is the sport. Ngayon, we also had yung ating storge, which is more of the familial love, and then we discuss also yung mania. So ngayon, we're going to the next type, which is the pragma. Okay, hi to Sir Alvin Singyan. Hello po, madam. Hello. Hi to Jade Azumi Dason. Hi to Sir August Pineda of Virginia. So yung pragma, there are people who prefer to be practical and realistic in their approach to all things in life, including love. So yung mga pragma, they experience love that combines the features of ludos and storge. Hello, Ma'am Helen Arceo Arciga. Hello, Teacher Kalagumo. Ayan. Thank you po. So, ano yung pragma? Yung pragma naman, ludos and storge. So, makikita nyo dyan, their approach in that they treat the process of looking for partners as a business-like search. Okay? Parang business deal. They cast their nets wide, catch as many partners as they can. Sila yung tinatawag na collect then select. Okay? Pragma type yun. Hello to batchmate Jennifer Kapati Shelo. Hi sis, stay safe. So, they cast their nets wide and then they collect and then they select. Pragmatic lovers use logic in how they look for a lifelong partner. They do not rely on their physical responses and hormones alone. After pinatubo, alita na Mickey Ticket Wapin po. And that is 1991 or 1995. So, maluwa na ne, Kongogos. Hi to Ian Torno. Ayan. So, as I've said, more practical pagdating sa pragma. Usually, they will be strict, sticking to those standards. Okay, may mga standards sila na gustong masunod and rejecting those that do not quite match up. You will find them looking closely into the other persons. Ayan, sila yung nag-check ng background, education, family history, religion, affiliations, habits, and interests. Their sexual desire and interest is usually aroused only when they meet the ideal man or woman. So, hindi, although ludic type sila, pero yung pagka-ludic type nila is because they, sa ludic type, they are more of a game, di ba? Dito naman sa pragma, they are more on a practical basis na kailangan makita nila yung ideal man or woman nila before that sexual drive will be, ano, ay, nakalimutan ko, baka may mga bata, sorry, last na kasi, Pero kahit last night, taas natin. Ito na.
Patnubay at gabay ng magulang ang kailangan. Maaaring may maseselang tema, lengguwahe, karahasan, sexual, horror o droga na hindi angkop sa mga bata. This program is rated SPG. It contains scenes with themes, language, violence, sex, horror, or drugs which may not be suitable for children. Strong parental guidance is advised.
Ayan, nakalimutan akong itaas. Nagsusimula na ako. Hi to Sis Jen Fabs. Ayan. Hi to Batchmate Michael Manaid David. Hello to Bapang Romel Kunanan. Ayan, hello po sa inyong lahat. Thank you for watching. So dito, yung sexual desire and interest ng pragma only when they are into their ideal woman or ideal man. The person that meets their standards. So this means that sexual attraction does not rank high on his list of priorities. Even he does not feel any attraction for that person. If the standards are met, then they can work out on the sexual side of things later on. Ito yung mga, ay, ginamit na yan yung utak na, na. Kasi, makwaltayta nga pang asawa, no? Kaya mekwaltaya, adang makanyan. There are this kind of lover. They do exist. More than romance, convenience is the focus of a pragmatic love. So, Rita, more of, sasabihin ng practical, realistic, and materialistic are more of the pragma type. So, kahit Deborah, basta atula ka Rita listan of the standards, the na requirement for an ideal man or woman, they can go with them. Okay, kahit na wala si, they could actually give themselves to them even though they are not sexually attracted. Hello, Sir Amael. Ayan, good evening. So, even though they are not sexually attracted, pag na-meet ng isang pragma lover yung kanyang ideal person, they go for it. More than romance nga, convenience is their number one na gusto. Hi to sis, hi Reggie and Rike, ayan. They have expectation of their partners or end of their relationship. And they want these expectations to be met. Their goals have to be common on complementary in order for him to consider her or as potential lifelong partner. Ano yung mga traits ng pragmatic lovers? The pragmatic lover can be quite cold when rejecting partners, okay? Hi to Koyang Marvin David. That do not meet the criteria or standards that they have previously set. This make them cold-hearted and ruthless, and they usually won't feel bad about being viewed as such. So sila yung talagang yan na itang imburina mo, makanyan practical ya talaga, bala mo yaman ni Nano na potang yan eburi talaga sasabihan na. Because that is the trait of a pragmatic lover. Ayan. Hello and hello kay Doktor at sa inyong mga dalaga. Ayan. So, the pragmatic lover as well will ask, what is it for me if I get into this relationship with this person? So more sila dun sa, anong makukuha ko? Kung sasama ako sa kanya, anong makukuha ko? Anong convenience magkakaroon ako kung sasama ako sa kanya? Ngayon, ano naman yung magiging, sabihin nating negative side pag pragmatic yung lover? Just like in business, a relationship founded on pragmatic love may turn sour when the business partners are no longer pulling the weight, so to speak. If somewhere along the way, their goals have been differentiated, or the other partner has become a burden to the other and is no longer contributing to the partnership, the relationship may go down to drain. There is a chance of the pragmatic lover becoming manic as well. So before we discuss yun, dun sa pragmatic lover, di ba kasi they are into convenience, meron silang certain standards, and they think that love is also a business. Parang tinitreat mo siya as a business. Ngayon, if you are with a pragmatic lover and suddenly there's a change on those standards, may tendency na mangyari na yung lover na yon maaalis yung kanyang desire for the other person. Why? Because the standards nagbabago sila. Okay? Hello to Alain Yap Chinkwangko. Ayan. Para ngayon lang kita nakita, Bes. Where have you been? Ayan. So, they also have this tendency to become manic. Bakit? Okay? Bakit sila nagmamanic? Having a predetermined or preconceived notion for this is Mr. Right and this is Miss Right has the tendency to render the pragmatic lover inflexible. So that when he finds someone that he feels drawn to but he does not meet 90% ng criteria nila, they will actually decline. So, ang mangyayari, kahit na may nararamdaman sila, if 90% ng requirements nila, alimbawa, dapat stable financially. Dapat may, kasi nga practical sila, di ba? Dapat may kotse. Dapat may sariling bahay. Dapat wala nang, dapat hindi nakikilam yung ganto. And then, so this is their Mr. Right. Eh kung may nangyari sa stability and the standard na meron yung partner na nakuha niya, so magkakaroon siya ng coldness. Kaya minsan, siling tinatawag na bala mo, wala silang puso. They are ruthless. They are very cold. Parang hindi sila masasaktan leaving other people when they are no longer convenient with the relationship. Are we call them users? Depende if you can say users if only one-sided. Pero may mga pragmatic lovers kasing they are capable of sharing what they have with that partner as long as yung standard nila ay naandoon, nakataas sila. So pag hindi nakataas yung standard, probably yun yung pwede mong sabihin users, na they just want what they want and then they run away, okay? And they are not scared of doing that, okay? Lalo na pag alam nila na medyo pabagsak na or something like that. Ayun, katula mo pa, Monebes, sige. Hi to Darwin Manalastas. Hi to Ma'am Cherry Cabrera. Ayan. Hello to Cecil. So, next. So, yung pragmatic. Ito yung hinihintay ng babe ko. Babe! Atso ka, babe. Mag-present ka, pen, babe. Hinihintay ng babe ko to eh. The last one is the agape love. This type of love, which is based on selflessness, is said to be a mix of eros and storge. So parang pagtitingnan mo, maganda siya, 'di ba? Kasi storge is of a familial love and eros is involvement of a plan for a future, of involving your emotions, planning for a better relationship and dying with that person that you love. So parang pinagsama siya. Eto babe, ito yata yung meron natin, babe. Ayan. When we talk of unconditional love or the love that is altruistic and does not demand or expect anything in return, that is agape love. This is considered to be love in its purest form, with the lover being selfless and willing to make sacrifices for the one he loves. This is the reason why it is also often equated with the religious or traditional type of love. They always say, saints and the martyrs are known and beloved for their selfless and giving nature. They have much agape love. So it does not come as a surprise to hear selfless people being called martyrs when it comes to love, because they are willing to do anything and everything for the other person. Pero meron ditong positive and negative. Mamaya, sabihin natin. Agape love is patient and does not demand for any form of reciprocation. Ito yung agape love, pag you are giving your love regardless kung mamahalin or hindi ka mamahalin, babalik nung taong minamahal mo. It sounds too good to be true, and Jan Robert Lee's survey did not turn up anyway who qualifies as agape lover, leading him to the conclusion that this type of love is the ideal and therefore not always realistic. Lee added that agape love is easier to feel for all humanity in general than for an individual. This is almost like saying that it's impossible for a person to feel unconditional love for a certain someone. Kasi nga, bakit? Agape love is selfless, without regard to his pain. May mga ganun nagmamahalin. They could give selfless love kahit nasasaktan sila. And they provide love excellently, okay? They are more of a giver of love. The agape lover is compassionate, kind, emulating an almost saintly devotion that most people would be impressed with, but will still probably scoffed at and not take seriously. Ito yung nagiging downside pag agape love ka, because you don't wait for other people, that other person to love you back or what. Some people will tend to take advantage of the love that you offer to other people. Sa agape love kasi, hi to Ati, hi D. Biliwang Santos, hi Ann, good PM, paki-shoutout ti Luan, Alvin naka, hi Luan, ayan, kiss Luan, mwah, yan. So, kasi dito there's no jealousy, there's no obsession, there's no possessiveness in how the agape lover treats his partner. He is more than happy to just be beside her or behind her whenever and whenever he needs her. Ayan. Ito yung mga tinatawag nating, sino gusto sumama sa akin? Tara, punta na tayong luneta. Mga martir, ayan. Ano na, binabaril kasama doon sa may luneta. The purity of agape love means that it has no preconceived standards, and so there won't be any judgment at all. Kasi when you love on, you do love on the purest sense, okay? You actually don't care who they are. Mapupunta ka dun sa ganung punto. Where are they from? Okay, what stability meron sila? Anong meron sila ngayon? Agape love can inspire the lover to seek for self-improvement. Tapos with your love, yung person na minamahal mo, you want to see that person to improve dun sa sitwasyon niya. And if he lacks in the sex department, he will show ready willingness to learn. Ayan. Kahit na wala siya ganun ka ano sa pagdating sa sex or what, dahil mahal niya yung tao, gagawin niya pa rin kahit ano, kasi mahal niya yung tao. Okay, what is the disadvantage of having agape love or the purest form of love? The agape lover may be opening himself or herself up to being taken advantage by other lovers. Ay, ngayon alam ko na. Ayan, that's why I'm always taken advantage ng mga ludic and the manic lovers. Yung mga players, yung mga kasi pag nagmamahal ka ng tunay, bigay mo lahat, 'di ba? Ginagawa mo lahat. Sabi nga, it's a purest form. You do not wait for other people to love you back. So, minamahal mo sila, you want them to improve. Tapos, you try your best to do best in bed, sa sex. Kasi hindi, because you desire it, you're not that kind of lover, but you give it. Kasi mahal mo yung tao. At pinoprovide mo yun kasi mahal mo yung tao. The thing is, itong mga ludic and manic lovers, ito, prone ang agape. Kasi yung ludic lover, alam niya yung agape. Yung agape kasi will do anything. And will not require commitment, and will not require obsession, and will not require obsession. So, ano nangyayari? So, si agape, bigay ng love. Si ludic naman, at saka si manic, kuha lang sila ng kuha. Yun yung downside ng having the purest sense of love. They keep on giving, while their partner will keep on taking and taking. And not giving anything in return because, hey, it's not expected of them anyway. Eh, diba na, conditional love na ka man. So, lakwandasan. Ayan. Oh, diba? Unrequited love. Ito yung mga sinesyon ko nung matagal na. Dito kayo, ito yung type of lover kayo. Oh, Sir Ams, ayan. Yung binigay mo yung buong-buo. Wala na natira. And it's unreciprocated. Why? Because your form of love is of that agape love. Pag agape love yung meron ka, binibigay mo talaga yung lahat. Ayun. So, ang nangyayari pag hindi ka rin, kahit sabihin mo na yung mga agape people, agape lover, they don't expect anything in return, they also get hurt. Okay? They also get tired and having that feeling of, oh, ano, parang tinutorture na namin. Tinutorture talaga namin yung sarili. Tapos, for long existence. Kasi yung mga agapan lover, ano eh, matagal silang magmahal. Ayan, the risk is very high that the agape lover will be nothing more than a carer in the eyes of the recipient of the affection. So, yun nangyayari pag agape lover. So, i-review natin, ha? Yung number one type is your Eros. Your Eros, yun yung more of the romantic side, naniniwala sa chemistry, naniniwala sa love at first sight, linalagay sa pedestal yung lover nila, and they also have a plan for the future. While the Ludos lover naman, yung mga ludic lover, yung under sa Ludos, they are the one that are not into commitment. They are not into commitment. Love is the game, sex is the sport, and you, the object, is the tool for that sport. So, paramihan ng award, paramihan ng babae, paramihan ng lalaki sa listahan. And they are very good in sex, they are outstanding in sex, and but they are afraid of commitment. So, pag na-attach na sila ng emotionally with the other people, what they do, they run away. Okay? They make something to run away. Ano yung sumunod? Yung storge. What is storge? This is the more of the familial type. Yung feeling that you have for your family members, to your friends, to your best friends. And also, pag yan, naging lover yan, they focus more on the development and growth of the family and the future of the family, forgetting that they have, that the partner also have some sexual needs or compassion. Nawawala yun sa kanila. So, Eros, Ludos, and then your Storge, and then your Mania. Your Mania, sila yung jealous type because they have so low self-esteem, but they are combination of Eros and Ludos. So, ang nangyayari, they're more of jealous type. Iniisip nila, pag nagsiselos sila, yun yung form of love nila. So, this one is kind of toxic relationship. So, they need a strong partner to have a very good relationship. Ngayon, yung next natin is Pragma. They are the practical type. They are the one who has ideal, Mr. Right, Miss Right, and they focus more on being practical. What is there for me? And then what they really set a standard. Dapat yung meron yon kahit na wala silang sexual desire or sexual attachment doon sa tao. Hi to Sir Ace Nava. Nakabukas na po ang Doña Arcelis sa May Mindpiece doon bago pumasok sa sakop sa tabi po ng Calcutta. Ayan. May mga ano din po si Sir panglinis ng mga ano pang disinfectant, alcohol and everything. Hi to Daddy Chloe listening for this last session, Ma'am. Thank you. Pa-shoutout po, salamat. Hello Daddy MJ, hello Mommy Reg, hello to Chloe, my love. Hi to Ate Island Luz Viminda Manalestas Nakpil. Galing na naman, Madam, and thank you. Hi to Captain Samya ng De La Paz. Ayan, hello po sa inyo lahat. Maraming salamat sa suporta na binibigay nyo. So, naputol po tayo dun sa Pragma. And then, yun nga, we have the agape love in which they believe in unconditional love. This is the purest form of love. And they can love without expecting anything in return. And they are there to always care and would always want a better future for the person that they love. Pero sila yung mga martyr na usually those who have agape love, yan pa yung iniiwan ng mga tao. Kasi nga alam nila that maiiwan din naman ako dito. Hi to Mitch. Ayan. Ngayon, Ngayon, the question. How to love and be loved in return? Kasi yung mga sessions natin ng session 1 until the end ng final session na to, we always would like to go back to talking about love. How to love nga ba and be loved in return? Ayan. Are you someone that is easy to love? Yan. Tanungin nyo yung sarili nyo habang nakikinig kayo. What do you have that will attract other people? Anong meron ka para ma-attract yung ibang tao sa inyo? What about you, okay, will grab the interest and draw them to you? On the other hand, what are you looking for in a person who you will love? What do you expect from loving these people? What future do you envision? And what kind of love are you capable of incidentally? Anong klase ka bang lover? Na figure out nyo ba? Hindi ko pwedeng tanongin eh kung anong klaseng lover kayo. Baka i-type nyo dan yung iba, ano, nahihiya sila kung anong type of lover sila. Having said that, yung mga type of lover na napag-usapan natin, pwede nating i-consider yung ano, paano mo nga ba maiiwasan na masaktan pagdating sa pag-ibig, di ba? Kasi yan yung talagang pinagmulan ng FB live session ni Teacher Mary. People asking me, brokenhearted, they want to move forward, to let go. Ano ba yung mga pinagdaanan natin? Living in a life of may jealous partner, living in a life with abusive partner. So, ang dami natin tinalakay. Pero in the ending, it was still love that we were talking about. One thing that you could always do, 'di ba? Ano yung sa ano, pag nagdudulo ako, pag, 'di ba? What do I always say? So kung naman sa 25 sessions, alam niyo na yung sinasabi ko pag as I always say. Oh, ano 'yon? Sige nga, sagot nga kayo. Oy, sumagot kayo kasi last session na 'to. Tapos niyan 3 minutes bago lalabas yung sagot niyo. Ha? Ano yung sinasabi ni teacher? As I always say, dugtungan nyo. Asan na yung sagot? Asan na kayo? Ito lang sumasagot. O sumasagot kayo, hindi ko pa rin nakikita. Diba lagi ko sinasabi, I as always say, you live to love. You love to live. You love to live. Okay, tell the people that you love them. Diba? Love to die, die to live. Hindi ko yun sinasabi. I always say you live so you could love. You live to love. And you love. You love to live. Gusto mong mabuhay. Diba? Nabubuhay ka para magmahal. Diba? At gustuhin mo, mahal mong mabuhay. Gusto mong mabuhay. Ayan. Live to love, love to live. Tama si Iya. Ayan. So, in this situation, hindi po mali to let the people you love them. Let them know. There's nothing wrong letting people know that you love them. Kasi in many instances, ayaw natin eh. Parang it's either you're afraid of rejection or teacher naman, 25 years na kami, alam na niyang mahal ko siya. Or si teacher naman, ganto, 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 diba? Hi to Papa Noel, Auntie Lynn, and Ellen. Ayan. This is often a problem among couples and those in loving relationships. Even when they have been in this relationship for a long time, they do not let the other know how they feel. Often they assume that since they are already in a relationship, loving each other is already a foregone conclusion. So, balo na na ito, matik na ito, teacher. Na balo na kaluguran ke, anak. Hi to Rin Andus. Ayan. Hi to Jem Nawa Ma'am. Ayan. Hello, thank you for watching. So, yun yung inaano natin na kahit matagal na po kayo, do not forget to tell people that you love them. Guess what? Some people still need reassurance. Kasi minsan pag na-feel nilang yung tao na hindi mo na napapakita na sasabing mahal mo sila, some people will just feel cold. I-interpret nila yun na you also don't like them or you don't even love them na. So you have you don't have to be afraid to tell them. Hi to Sir Bong Canlas, na late ka. Hi to Wilbur Mahimer. Yan. Some people still appreciate being told that they are loved. And some people actually deserve to be told that they are loved. Huwag nating kakalimutan na ang bawat isa sa atin, we always, okay, want to be reassured that somebody is loving us, di ba? Ngayon, yan, totoo daw, sabi ni Rin. As much as we would want our partners to be mind readers, okay? It is most likely that they are not. Okay? Di ba nabanggit ko na yun sa inyo? Even us, psychotherapists, counselors, teachers, or even doctors, we don't read minds. No matter how secure you both are in your relationship and love for each other, it is still encouraged to let them know about it. Kailangan alam nila na mahal mo sila. It's not only pertaining to your romantic lovers or what, your mom, your dad, your sister, your friends, okay? This is not overacting. Like for me, Teacher Len, Ma'am Weng, and my babe, we always say, I love you. Parang kahit lang sa messenger, we would like to remind each other that we love each other. Hindi siya nawawala yung, I love you, madam, I love you, diba? Love you, babe, I love you, teacher, I love you. Why? Because, sinabi ko nga, life is not promised to anybody. And tomorrow is not promised to anybody. Maybe not in so many words. Minsan hindi sa words, di ba? But in actions. The way you care for people, the way you take good care of them, whether this is very big or small. A soft touch. Di ba? Hawakan mo. A warm smile. Ayan. Mag-aagree ba kayo? Sabi nila, maganda daw akong umiti. Ayan. Palagay nyo, maganda ba talaga? A short note. Ako to, gusto ko to. Nung sulat-sulat ako ng Pero minsan, pag nakuha mong partner, hindi siya ganon. Mahirap din, di ba? And even single bloom plucked from the garden can speak volumes. Ganking wami mo kaya tantalbus mo kamuti mamweng, ne? O taminuli yay Sir Alvin. Saga namin. Kaya retang ilang-ilang mo. Harvest mo lang. Right? Nevins? Ayan. And you have to do it repeatedly, Ma'am Helen. So, itang sweet, tamo, diba? Oh. You have to show gampinulis mia powers or something like that because it is parang simple ways but touches your heart so deep. We often hear people say that in order to be loved by others, you have to what? Ito pag hindi nyo nasagot, hindi ako mag-ano. Hindi ako magpa-final session. Before you can love others, ano muna dapat mong gawin? It is most likely that what? You have to what? Naghihintay ako ng sagot. Hanggang walang mag-flash na sagot, hindi ako mag-move on. What's the answer? We often hear people say that in order to be loved by others, you have to love yourself. Perfect! In the end, yung pinakamakulit ko pa rin estudyante na si Vince ang valedictorian ng klaseng ito. Ayan. In order to be able to love other people, you have to love yourself. Ayan si Iya din. You have to love yourself first. Kung meron ako, ang Teacher Mary's FB live session na may iwan sa inyo, ito yung gusto ko malaman nyo. That for you to be able to love others on a agape level, you have to love yourself first. Okay? PM lang daw kayo kay ano, kay Vince. Hi to Ma'am Geraldine Pandakan. Happy Mom's Day. Hello kay Jiro, Mami. Hi to Auntie Aula Canilao. Hi to a friend, Lon Anisete. What a great insight from Teacher Mary. Thank you very much. Kasi ito yung gusto kong i-share talaga sa inyo for all the session. Mapapansin nyo ulit-ulit siya. Because based sa experience, even you pour your love to other people, if you don't love yourself, you will end up with nothing. So, uulitin ko, we often hear people say that in order to be loved by others, you have to love yourself first. This is actually very, very true. First-hand experience, Teacher Mary's life. Because you cannot expect someone else to love you when you do not even think loving. Diba? Kahit anong klaseng lover ka, kung kahit anong saan ka dun sa types a theory of love ka, if you do not know and you do not see yourself worth loving, how can other people love you? By loving yourself first, you will have the confidence to move forward and express your love for someone. Kasi pag mas malakas yung loob mo, na alam mo mahal mo yung sarili mo, you will never be afraid of rejection. You will never get jealous. You will never be feeling that possessiveness na akin lang siya. You will never be obsessed with somebody. Rather, you are willing to give that love unconditionally, share it with people without any regret, without any grudges, without any remorse. You give yourself because you are full, because you are complete, because you are in love with yourself. So you will have the confidence to move forward, express that love for the other person. By loving yourself, you are sending that person the silent message that he is making the right decision by choosing to love you. Because there are a lot of people out there who are capable of doing good sex, who have a lot of money and give you the standard that you would like. Pogi, maganda, sexy, every qualifications that you are looking, malawak ang mundo. Sa 7 billion tayo, meron at meron kang makikita. But unless you learn to love yourself, lalampas at lalampas sila dahil hindi mo pinapakita that you are worth loving. So ano dapat mong gawin, di ba? You send the silent message that I am worth loving. I am capable of loving because I know how to love myself. And I know that somebody would be there for me to love me. Ultimately, healthy and fulfilling relationship dictate that in order for you to receive love, you also have to give it. Okay? So yun yung dun sa dulo na lagi ko sinasabi na Live to love, love to live, diba? Don't waste your time. Tell the people you love them. Because the more love you give, the more love you receive. This is really, really true. Because it gives and takes scenario that should have no room for selfishness. So, this is the kind of love that will make this world a better place. A love that is so pure, okay, selfless, despite all the definitions of love floating around this. Diba? Pagbata ka pa, love is a mystery. Love is like a rosary full of mystery, di ba? May paganyan-ganyan tayo. Love is a splendor thing. Love is sacrifice. Love is blind. Love is kind. Love is love. Love is ba, 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 ba. You all have a different definition of love because you define love the way you feel love. Kaya nga yan yung word na walang exact definition sa dictionary na natatanggapin lahat ng ibang tao. So love remains to be one of the most mysterious emotions. Until now, non-stop naman yung pag-i-study ng psychology about love. We are entirely powerless in expressing it. Ito yung mali ng natin that we tend to withhold our feelings and not show the love. Tapos po tating milyari kitang tao ka rin kagagaga, sana pe bakit po yung lugod ko kaya ka, sana abalo mo ka, luguranda ka. Okay? If you love yourself, matitigil kasi yung inhibition. If you love yourself, you are not afraid to tell one person that I love you. And then if that person say na I don't love you, you will not get hurt because you know. You don't insist on anything. You just want to know that person to that you love them. Diba? So yun yung kung meron man tayong pinagsamahan for 25 nights. Successful tayo 25 nights. Halos isang buwan na nagsama-sama tayo. Kaya lang sabi nga na ito yung tinatawag na love din eh. When you know how to love, you know how to, you know, give time for certain things that you also love. So, Teacher Mary has to do another thing that I could not always go on sharp at 8 o'clock na maka-live kayo. So maglala session tayo. But it does not mean that Teacher Mary will not be kumbaga absent na siya dito sa social media or what. Actually, I'm not going to be absent. In fact, my son is so supportive of me. I love you, Maverick Ryan. He told me yesterday that I could, you know, do the continue yung YouTube and do some of my thoughts and my nuggets. Pero sabi niya masyado mahaba, ma'am. Kaya ang ginawa niya, Teacher Mary's 2 cents. Okay? Find the value with your 2 cents. Yung kung anong opinion mo, may halaga. Kahit kung ano'y nasa puso mo, may halaga. So, yun yung susunod na kabanata ng kay Teacher Mary. Although, hindi natin alam papaano or what. Probably, I'll just be recording or doing the vlog. I really don't know. Pero, sa session, mang natitira ko yung sa Kapampangan, Tibuan. And I would like to tell everybody as well that this account, the Mary Ann Biliwang account will go back to private. Okay po? Lahat po ng gustong mag-follow kay Teacher Mary has to go to the Teacher Mary's 2 cents page. Yun po yung ilike ninyo. Teacher Mary's 2 cents na FB page. doon ko po ilalagay yung mga public. Ngayon po, dito sa aking original personal account, ayan, I will be, okay, i-unfriend ko po yung personal na hindi ko po talaga kilala or wala tayong naging contact or hindi tayo we don't say hi or hello or anything. So I will be clearing also my FB friend list on this account. And then you can just follow me dun sa page na Teacher Mary's Two Cents. Why? Because I would also like to reserve back the privacy of my account. Ayan. So, yon. So, magpa-private po ulit ang Mary Ann Biliwang. Naintindihan po natin, baka po pag follower ko po kayo and hindi ko po kayo pa nakakausap or not personal, I might put you on the unfriend list. Pero wag po kayo magalit, pwede po you can follow or either you go to Teacher Mary's Two Cents na page. Ayan. Nagkakaintindihan po tayo? Ayan. So, I would like to thank lahat po ng sumuporta kay Teacher Mary. Okay? Number one, Doc Noemi, my babe. Na kachikahan ko after kong mag-live. Ma'am Weng, Sir Alvin, Lon Anisete, Vince na makulit, Mommy Connie, Mommy Liza, ang ever supportive and loving na Tita Helen, Arceo Arciga, ang kanyang mga friendship, Ma'am Maika, Ma'am Ems, Ma'am Elvisia Balboa, Laos Balboa, yung mga nagsusupport din na mga sina Sir Bong Canlas, ayan, si Mami Marlin, sina Sir Ace Nava, Ma'am Chorigala, Sir Avel Antonio, Sir Amael, ayan, si Ma'am Marie Cris, si Sis Ana Gonzalez, ayan, lahat po kayo, Mami Liza, Mami Seng, Teacher Len, lahat po kayo na sumuporta dito sa aking 25 sessions ng FB Live. Maraming salamat po. At sa mga friend po natin sa Manu Live, si Ma'am Pao, si Kat, yung po kasing ginagamit niyang FB page, FB account, so kung gusto nyo hanapin. Ganun din po si Sis Waling Babe, Rowena Vitaliab. And then, maraming salamat po din kay Ma'am Hershey, Mayrina, Fibo David ng Fibo Photography, Mr. Fixit. Lahat po kayo na hindi pa kasi nasa modified, enhanced community quarantine. So, hindi pa rin po pwede lumabas. You call Mr. Fixit. Nag-fix po sila ng kailangan yung i-fix sa bahay. They do groceries. They deliver food. They can cater small parties like maximum of 20 according to the dun sa guidelines dun sa house ninyo. Ayan. So, Kap Melcher and Vilma Kaluwag. Maraming salamat po sa suporta na 25 nights nyo po ako nakasama. Ayan. Nabanggit ko po ba kayong lahat? Sino po yung hindi ko nabanggit na laging nandyan? Si Sis Risa Garcia. Si Sis Agnes. Ayan. Kayo pong lahat. Kung hindi ko po kayo mabanggit lahat, salamat po. Salamat sa suporta ninyo. Ayan. So, for teachers, Teacher Mary's final 2 cents. Ayan. Life, sabi nila, is you only live once. Para sa akin, you live every day. Because the moment you wake up, buhay ka eh, di ba? So you live every day, but it's actually how hindi yung nabuhay ka ng minsan dito sa mundo. It is not more of counting kung nabuhay ka ng, it's more of, not of the days. Okay? Yung life natin dito is not counting of the days, but it is counting on how you live your life. And for me, after learning the value of myself, learning to love myself, there are also three things that I would like you to remember as Teacher Mary. Number one is love. Okay? Magmahal lang kahit masaktan, magmahal pa rin. Kahit anong mangyari, huwag mong bibitawan ang magmahal. Pangalawa, compassion. Have compassion for other people. If you cannot help them, just don't hurt them. Kung hindi ka makakatulong, huwag ka na lang manakit. Ito yung mga rules of, parang sa akin, I live my life. Kung di ka rin tutulong, huwag ka na lang manakit. And number three, kindness. Kahit minsan kailangan mong mamili on being right or being kind, I always would like me, myself, to choose being kind. Kasi things on earth, kung anong meron natin dito, may iwan lang natin dito. Pero pag nawala kasi tayo sa mundo, ang iiwanan natin is how did I live my life? Na you imagine that when people looked at you, they would say na she lived her life well. He lived his life well. Yung legacy na yon, may iiwan dun sa mga taong minamahal mo. That is enough. When they say how good as a person as you are, yun yung masarap na iwan sa mga taong minamahal natin. Higit sa ano pa mang bagay na meron kang iiwan sa kanila. Yung alam ng taong, even though they will be grieving on your loss, they would say na, my daughter, or my wife, or my girlfriend, or kung anong relasyon nyo, they would say na, you live your life well. So, wag po natin kakalimutan na you have to love, to be compassionate, and to remain kind. And, as I always say, wag natin kalimutan, you live to love. Nabubuhay ka para magmahal. You have to love to live. Kailangan mahalin mo ang mabuhay. Do not waste your time. Tell the people you love them. Because the more love you give, the more love you will receive. Thank you very much. With a grateful heart, I would like to say thank you for staying with me for 25 nights. Daig ko pa ang teledrama na sinusubaybayan nyo ng 8 o'clock. At dun sa mga nagselos na mister, please lang po, huwag nyo pong pagalitan yung mister nyo. Marami po silang natututunan dito kay Teacher Mary. Wala po akong intensyon mang agaw or kung ano man po. No po, yung mga, madami kasi nag-aano sa akin, nagsiselos na daw yung asawa nila kasi 8 o'clock pa lang nakatutok na sila sa akin. Ayan po, wag po kayong mag-alala. Ayan. So, sa lahat ng supporters, thank you very much. Thank you for the lessons. We'll keep them in mind. Thank you, Lon. Ayan. Love, compassion, and kindness. Noted po. Thank you very much, Mother Joby Bondoc Henson. Ayan. Ang pinakamagaling din na designer sa fashion. And to Iya Mandap, ayan. Kahit pinapagalitan kita, you know how much I love you. So, to all the people, let's go back. Okay? Let's find our way back into love. Okay? So, huwag niyong kakalimutan, magmahal. So, this is Teacher Mary signing off for Teacher Mary's FB Live tonight. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful night. I love you all. And with a grateful heart, I would like to say, I love you so much. Love you all.